Hi friends, welcome back to Simplify India, your ultimate learning partner. Today, we are going to learn the important terms related to tax computation in capital gains. Before proceeding further, since this video is the part 4 of our series on capital gains and its taxation, we recommend you people to watch part 1, part 2 and part 3 of the series for the better understanding of the concept. Let us start with today's topic. First, we are going to learn the format for computation of short-term capital gain or short-term capital loss. In the format, first we have to consider sales proceeds. From the sales proceeds, we have to deduct cost of acquisition, cost of improvement, and the selling expenses. When we deduct all these three items from the sales proceeds, we arrive at short-term capital gain or short-term capital loss. Next, let us learn the format for computation of long-term capital gain or long-term capital loss. Here, in case of long-term capital gain or loss, we have to consider the indexation benefit, which is applicable only in case of long-term capital asset. Here, we have to take sales proceeds, from which we have to deduct index cost of acquisition, index cost of improvement, and the selling expenses. When we deduct all these three items from the sales proceeds, we arrive at long-term capital gain or long-term capital loss. Now, let us learn the formula for calculation of index cost of acquisition. That is, cost of acquisition into CII value in the year of sale divided by CII value in the year of purchase. Next, we have the formula for computation of index cost of improvement. That is, cost of improvement into CII value in the year of sale divided by CII value in the year of improvement made. Now, let us learn what are the CII values which we have used in the calculation of index cost of improvement and the index cost of acquisition. CII values is an index used to calculate the notional increase in the value of an asset due to inflation. Here, we have listed out different CII values for the respective years which we have to utilize in the calculation of capital gains. Now, you might wonder what we have to consider as the CII values for the assets which has been purchased before 2001-2002. Here, we have the solution for the same. In such a case, we have to consider both the actual cost of acquisition and the FRV value as on 1st April 2001. By comparing both of this, we have to consider any of the value whichever is higher, and this value have to be used for calculation. And the CII value will always be 100 if the asset has been purchased before 1st April 2001. Now, let us know some of the important points to be remembered before making calculation for capital gains. If in case the assessee has owned the asset without incurring the cost of acquisition, like he may have got the asset in the form of gift or as ancestral property, in such a case, the cost of acquisition will be the cost incurred by the previous owner of the asset. And in case if the improvement is made for an asset before 1st April 2001, should be ignored, and only the improvement made after 1st April 2001 should be considered for indexing. And in case of advance, if the advance money is received and forfeited during the year 2013-14 and early to that previous year, such money should be subtracted from the cost of acquisition. Whereas if any of the advance money received and forfeited after the year 2013-14, such amount has to be taxed under the income from other sources, and it will not be deducted from cost of acquisition. In case of depreciable assets like plant and machinery, it will always be a short-term capital asset. For this, we have to use this particular format for computation of short-term capital gain or loss, where we have to take the sales proceeds, from which we have to deduct the depreciation under return on value method, from which we arrive at short-term capital gain or loss. In case of debentures and bonds, indexation is not required as it is not affected by the inflationary changes. In case of self-generated assets like goodwill, patent, trademark, etc., there will be no cost of acquisition. This is all about the important terms related to taxation in capital gains. So friends, please be stay tuned to our channel as we are coming up with the next part of this series where you're going to learn the computation of capital gains in income tax with problems. Thanks for watching Simplify India. Please to support us by subscribing our channel.